nation runs on NOAA satellites.
Doing satellite operations is not as easy as just pushing a button on a keyboard.
We have a lot of data coming in, a lot of data going out, used a whole lot of different ways throughout the world.
It's a cast of thousands, believe it or not. Here, I mean, this is the forefront, this is the trenches.
You hit that button, you send out of your database a command to the satellite, but what you really don't realize is that it traveled thousands of miles to your ground station. It went as high as 20,000 miles up, went to the satellite, told the satellite what to do, the satellite telemetry changed, and then it would literally come back to you in a blink of an eye. That chain of events requires a lot of time, a lot of distance, a lot of people, a lot of resources.
Our data is national critical data.
When you see a forecast that's provided to you on television by your local forecaster, all that originates from NOAA, and the heart of that is our NOAA satellites.
Satellite, as it flies over the ground station, usually have maybe 10 to 12 minutes where it's going to be in view, and then it's going to pass out of view.
So in 12 minutes, you have to quickly ascertain the status of the satellite to see if its health and safety is good, then start bringing down the data, recorded data, from the orbit revolution.
We have to go ahead and dump that to the ground station, where it's recorded on the ground, and then after the satellite leaves the station circle, then we go ahead and post-ship bring all that data in, actually into the site here, so that it can be distributed and processed.
The U.S. military does take information from our spacecraft, the environmental data from our spacecraft, to use in their forecast for tactical purposes.
It's information about the weather, it's information about the soil density content. It just allows them to be able to make decisions real time that they have in the field that they can't get any other way quickly.
This is a 24/7 operations. We're never closed, of course.
We collect data for search and rescue.
We had a young girl, 16-year-old Abby Sunderland, a rogue wave hit her mast, not broke it, and capsized her boat. She fortunately had search and rescue transmitter on her boat that was activated and allowed us to triangulate from NOAA's satellites, POES and GOES, and give her location to people who could go out to rescue her. It's the imagination what you could do with the information. The whole point is to bring it down, and what can you do with it?
I often think of Hurricane Katrina and how many lives were saved because folks got up in the morning who lived in those areas that were under the warnings or under the watches and saw that image of that Category 5 hurricane in the Gulf of Mexico and said, I'm leaving. How many lives were saved because of our satellites? That's what we're all about in our satellite operations.